around today's successful young man. I'm not saying that in any egotistic way at all. Because
Linda can't cook. She reads books.
The Who.
Cindy can't sew. But I'd rather know. Mary Ann with the shaky hands. What they've done to a man. No shaky hands.
Pop music was once disseminated through vast promotional expeditions. The Who journey 15,000 miles in 6 weeks. 800 miles a day for an engagement is nothing. Increasingly, the strain of such tours forces ambitious pop musicians away from live performance and into the womb-like recording studio. The song thus becomes an electronic creation. It exists only on record. The first Beatle LP was made in a day. Their recent Sgt. Pepper song cycle took 3 months and 700 hours of studio time. Mozart wrote Don Giovanni in 7 weeks.
Mary Ann with the shaky hands. What they've done to a man, those shaky hands.
Kind of effect. That's why pop music is crucial to today's art. And it's crucial that it should remain art. And it is crucial that it should progress as art.
There's this huge cluster of scooters outside a very scruffy-looking pub in Harrow. And I went in and there with the Who. And where there was a distinct feeling of the presence of evil and of something which you can only describe as revolutionary. I mean, revolutionary in the sense of blood, revolutionary in the sense of a complete upheaval of everyone's ideas.
I don't have a love affair with a guitar. I don't polish it after every performance, etc., etc. I play them, you know. Our actual intention is to play out all the adrenaline and all the aggression and show the audience that you are a frustrated character, that you do want to get something out of your system and you do want to do it in front of them.
The cost of a pop group's equipment, guitars, drums, amplifiers, speakers and microphones, is about £1,000, $2,500. In Peoria, Illinois, the Who play out their adrenaline at the Opera House.